Hi, let's go through the Hyde linear concrete cover. Quite a specialist product. Let me show you some installed. Concrete linear system comes in two parts. One is the lid and the other is the formwork that creates the cavity for the lid. I'll just go through a couple of features you need to know early in the job. One is that plastic channel is not included in our kit. This is an Everhard system. You can buy that wherever you like. The other, it's stainless steel. Don't put acid anywhere near it. It's suitable for pedestrian traffic only, and it takes normal water control, not that rare storm event. So just be aware of that when you specify this product. The Hyde linear system is grate free and removable. In a really heavy weather event, you can easily pull out one of the grates. As we talked about, the Hyde linear kit system comes in two components. One is the lid. The Hyde lid comes with four welded on bridges to the base and the plastic lugs through the middle. Really simple. It also comes with a keyway. The keyway clips in to both ends of the lid. This is optional, and if you're doing more than one lid, you may need to only have one at one end to access the lids. Concrete linear lid, we've just spoken about. Separate and ordered separately is the formwork that creates the channel. It can be installed permanently in the channel, or you can remove it after this concrete's cured. In the formwork kit, you have two sized panels that come with a kit. We have four spaces that give you the correct width of the channel. And we have two end caps to keep the formwork separated and finished at both ends. Packets of lugs. And then also we have the timber cover plate. The timber cover plate stops the screed going into the drain and allows the correct width across between these side channels. Today, on our display table, we've set up two linking or two butting lids and channels and formwork. So I'm going to take this apart and explain the function of each part of the components and how they're put together. This set has been set up on top of the Everhard channel, and this is your finished height. This will be set up wire tied from the lugs or masking tape or duct tape holding it together across while you set up and set the levels. This needs to be done at early stages prior to the major pour. Let's deassemble this so we can see the components. The duct tape really is here to hold the product securely to the channel. That's an option to wire ties. Then we have the cover plate. The cover plate works really well if you overlap it between two channels. That'll support the links between the two lids. In between the side formwork is our spacer. These spaces need to be located in the position of the bridge within the lid. Each bridge will have its own spacer. Also on the formwork kit is two end brackets. These end brackets have a little protrusion to wrap around the edge of the formwork sides. If you're butting or aligning two lids, you'd cut that edge off and create a new spacer. The spacer neatly fits in between the two aligning formwork sides. Let's just imagine the concrete fully poured in sight. The lid's full of concrete and we're ready to go. We're going to remove the cover plate through the entire system. You're going to remove the spaces that have been located at the bridge location of the lid. The spaces will pull out. The concrete's pressured these lids back into place. This will allow the lid to slip into location. And once the lid's in position, completely seamless with two water easement clearances.